स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 8A 8B लेसन नंबर 11 रिवोल्ट ऑफ 1857 द पॉइंट्स एज आई मेंशन इन द बोर्ड फर्स्ट पॉइंट ह्यूमिलिएशन ऑफ बहादुर शाह जाफर टू ह्यूमिलिएशन ऑफ बहादुर शाह जाफर टू हु वाज बहादुर शाह जाफर टू बहादुर शाह जाफर टू वाज द लास्ट मुगल एम्पेरर नाउ व्हाट हैपेंड टू हिम बहादुर शाह जाफर was requested by the sepoys of India to take the leadership of their revolt. Initially, Bahadur Shah Zafar refused to accept their leadership since he was physically and mentally ill. But after the constant efforts after having taken many initiatives by the sepoys of India, they decided to convince the last Mughal Emperor Bahadur Shah Zafar to accept their leadership. So after few days acquaintance with the sepoys of India, Bahadur Shah Zafar came to a conclusion that the leadership of the sepoys for him might bring him honor, not dishonor, because he had been dishonoring by the British government. Although he was the last Mughal emperor, but he had no distinction, he had no honor, and he was leading a very unhappy life. That's why the sepoys, whenever they approached him to be the king of Hindustan, he felt proud. He recalled that he belonged to the Mughal, that great Mughal family, that great Mughal empire. And then he accepted their leadership. And the revolt of 1857 scattered here and there in different parts of our country, different states of India. Although the British decided to suppress the revolt of 1857, yet the strong leadership of some rulers of India encouraged the sepoys of India, like the rulers of Kanpur, the ruler of Jhansi. They all encouraged the sepoys of India. But in fact, as soon as the revolt was suppressed by the British, Bahadur Shah Zafar had become an absconder. Where was he? No one knew. That he was going to be imprisoned, he knew. That's why he remained inside the Humayun's tomb for months. One traitor disclosed it, and the British came to know that he took shelter inside the Humayun's tomb, and from there he was arrested. As soon as he was arrested, his two sons were there, and Bahadur Shah was humiliated at the hands of the British, since he took the leadership of the sepoys. So the life of Bahadur Shah and his family members came to an end, except the wife of Bahadur Shah. But Bahadur Shah Zafar's wife also led a very miserable life. As soon as her husband was sent to Rangoon, a fort, where while staying there at Rangoon, Bahadur Shah left his last breath. Next point, annexation of major states of India. You know, there are so many important states of India had been ruling independently, but the British policy of expansion forced them to come to their clutches. One after one, state of India was annexed by the British. The expansionist policy of the British forced them to sign the treaties they introduced. The policy of expansion of Lord Wellesley, subsidiary alliance, the expansionist policy of Lord Dalhousie, the doctrine of lapse, annexed so many states of India, one after one. The states which were annexed by the expansionist policies of the British two states antagonized the British. They declared war against the British. The states were Kanpur, Jhansi. Although the Sipahis of Ayodh antagonized British, chased the British soldiers from their capital Lucknow, and the British had to face tough resistance against the Sipahis of Lucknow, because a large number of Sipahis, they belong to Lucknow, the capital of Ayodh. They joined the Sipahis, and other people also joined the Sipahis. They belong to Lucknow, the capital of Ayodh. Since their Nawab was dismissed by the British by bringing false allegation of misgovernance, and Nawab's wife Hazrat Mahal led the battle from Ayodh. But afterwards, you know, the British captured one after one states of India, but in fact, in course of annexation the states of India, the British felt that it was due to their technical faults and mistakes. They forced the Sipahis involved in an agitation which should not have been done. That kind of mistake they committed, and decided to change certain policies in the structure of governance. Next point, discrimination among Indian Sipahis. So many Indian Sipahis were not interested to cross the Black Sea because it was against their religion and religious practice, but they were forced to cross the Black Sea, and an act also was passed by the British. Under the terms of that act, they were forced to go abroad for fighting against the enemies of Britain. But in fact, the sepoys were isolated from their society as soon as they got back from abroad. Why? Because they crossed Black Sea. So the British forcefully harmed the religious sentiments of Indians from the very, very beginning. But as soon as the British introduced Enfield rifle among the Indian sepoys to use, the sepoys resented. Why? Because there was a system of using the cartridges of that rifle that before loading the cartridges into the rifles, its cartridges were to be bitten off. But the cartridges were made of fat of pig and cow. Both the two animals were the most important factors for both the Hindus and Muslims. The Hindus had sacred animal. Cows were the sacred animal of the Hindus, and pig the Muslims disliked. So both the two communities of India refused to use the cartridges of the Enfield rifle, since its paper, which was covered because the cartridges which was covered with greased paper, the people realized that, the people came to know that it was made of fat of cows and pigs, and that paper was to be bitten off with the teeth of the soldiers. The soldiers did not want to beat up it with their teeth. Why? Because it was made of fat of cows and pigs. So it harmed the religious sentiments of the Hindus and Muslim sepoys. That's why they refused to use the cartridges. They refused to use the Enfield rifle introduced for them. The first protest started from Barhampur in West Bengal, in the district of Murshidabad. Barhampur was the first place from where the sepoys started agitation against the British and did not want to use the Enfield rifle. That wave of protest reached Barakpur. So the Barakpur 37th battalion refused to use, under Mangal Pandey, the head constable, directly chased the British. Since in Bengal he belonged to a Brahmin family, he realized that it harmed the sentiments of the Hindus. And as soon as he heard it, the news of Barhampur, he also instructed other sepoys not to use the Enfield rifle, but he was forced to use, and he refused, and then he killed one British officer. As soon as he killed the British officer, he was caught, and later he was executed. So these reasons, my dear students, only because of that reason, the sepoy mutiny is considered as the mutiny of the sepoy, since the sepoys protested the system of the introduction of a new rifle, Enfield rifle. The sepoys refused against the introduction of a new rifle, the Enfield rifle. That's why the sepoy mutiny was taken place in various parts of India, one after one. And this is the discrimination among the Indian people. discrimination. And last point, British policy of expansion, the British introducing their policy of expansion, Lord Wellesley's policy of subsidiary alliance, as I taught you earlier in detailed form, Lord Dalhousie, Lord Wellesley's policy of subsidiary alliance, Lord Dalhousie's policy of doctrine of lapse brought almost all states of India under their control, and those states who protested against it, they declared war against them. Although they had to face tough resistance against some states like Jhansi, like Kanpur, Ayodhya, yet ultimately they were able to annex it. So under this expansionist policy, so many Indian states were annexed by the British. The last one, reaction among the Orthodox Hindus. The Orthodox Hindus reacted against the introduction of new reforms, the reforms which they did not expect from the British. The British forcefully introduced it under the inspiration of some educationists like Raja Ram Mohan Roy and, you know, some distinguished educationists like Raja Ram Mohan Roy, you know, Jyotiba Phule, Narayan Guru, Swami Dwanand Saraswati, Swami Vivekananda, who started the Reformation movement from the very beginning, encouraged Indian elite. They received Western education and discarded the old traditional views and systems of the among the Indians. The British Governor General Lord William Bentinck strongly supported the stance of Indian educationists and reform new things, and also declared the old traditional practices illegal. And this harmed the Indian Orthodox people. It harmed the sentiments. And ultimately that wave reached far and wide. But although their resentment reached British headquarters, but the British did not stop reforming the Indian society. They discarded the views of the Orthodox people, the conservative people of India, up to this, my dear students. Thank you.